Hello, my name is Kaylee, and today we are going to focus on mathematical equations for kinetic and potential energy. Before we start this lesson, make sure you've watched the video, Conservation and Types of Energy, so you understand the concepts before diving into the math. The two main energy types we'll focus on are kinetic and potential energy. They each have their own equations that use algebra, but let's do a quick overview of the energy types first. From our energy checklist, we know there's two important things for kinetic energy. We need a mass and how heavy the thing that is moving is, and the velocity or how fast the thing is moving. And from our energy checklist for potential energy, we know that the two most important things are mass, or how heavy the thing at rest is, and how high off of the ground the thing at rest is. Keeping in mind our energy checklist, let's first take a look at the equation for kinetic energy. It goes, kinetic energy equals 1/2 the mass of the object times the velocity of the object squared. Remember from algebra, we can use variables to represent certain numbers or quantities. So we can also write this equation, Ek equals 1/2 mv squared. And this may look a little bit more scary, but let's break it down. We use the variable E to represent energy, and we put the little k down below so we can remind ourselves that what we are calculating is the kinetic energy. And now remembering our energy checklist for kinetic energy, we need mass and velocity. And we can see right here how the kinetic energy depends on those things. The M stands for mass and the V stands for velocity. Now using the rules of algebra, we can see that if the M or the mass gets bigger, the kinetic energy will also get bigger. And the same with V or velocity. If the velocity of the object gets faster, the object will have more kinetic energy. And the same idea applies if the mass gets smaller or the velocity is slower. The kinetic energy will be less. So good job. Using algebra and our energy checklist, we now have a pretty good idea of how Ek equals 1/2 mv squared represents kinetic energy. Now let's focus on the equation for potential energy. It goes, potential energy equals mass of the object times the gravity constant times height. And just like we did for the kinetic energy equation, we can use variables to represent these quantities. So we can also write the equation Ep equals mgh. And here again, we use the variable E to represent energy, and we use the P down below to remind us that what we are calculating is the potential energy. And remembering our energy checklist, the two things that potential energy depends on is mass and the height of the object. So from the equation, we can see how energy depends on these two things, the M or the mass of the object, and the h is the height of the object off the ground. And again, using those rules from algebra, we can see that as the mass or the height, the m or the h, get bigger, the object will have more potential energy. And likewise, if m or h or m or the mass and the height get smaller, the object will have less potential energy. But what about that g? So that g opens up a whole can of physics worms, but we can simplify it down for us today. So you've probably heard of a thing called gravity. It's what keeps your feet on the ground and the moon in orbit around the Earth. And you've probably noticed that gravity doesn't seem to change. You don't wake up in the morning and sometimes float around your house. And that's because gravity is a constant. It doesn't change. And we call that little g the acceleration due to gravity. And this is a very complex idea in physics, and we don't need to get into all of the details right now. For now, we just need to remember that on planet Earth, the acceleration due to gravity is a constant of 9.8 meters per second squared. And we'll get into what that means later. For now, we just know that the little g isn't as mysterious as we thought. So, way to work through those ideas. Now we've built up a better understanding of how EP equals MGH represents potential energy. So now we have an energy checklist for kinetic and potential energy, and we also have the equations to go along. But there is one more important thing that we should discuss. Energy can never be created or destroyed. And we already have learned that energy can be transferred between two different types. And we saw with our skateboarder how potential energy can turn into kinetic energy and back and forth. So with our equations, we can really easily see how energy transfers from potential energy to kinetic energy and back again. And it means when there's no friction, an object is moving away or towards the ground, potential energy will equal kinetic energy. So we can also write this as MGH equals 1/2 mv squared. And this equation can tell us all kinds of things. So check out the next video about the equations for friction and thermal energy, and then we'll do some math. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.